Hey everybody, welcome back. This is Mr. Campbell from MrCampbellRocks.com. Today we're talking about how to add drawings to notes or images in your notes in Google Keep. We are using the G Suite Learning Center. You can follow all that information here. So we're gonna go with the desktop first, then we'll go with the iPad, then we'll go with a mobile device, which is an Android device. So what we're going to do here is we're going to add a drawing. And so when we add a drawing, there's a couple different things that we can do. We can actually just add a drawing by itself, or what we can do is we can annotate an image or some text if we have a screenshot or something like that. So we'll show you both of those ways and how to do that on all three devices. So to take a new note on Keep, you're going to click on this little drawing thing here, and what you're going to do is you're going to get a whiteboard here, and we'll go through all the tools, but I want to draw something first because it's easier to show you the tools as we're going. So again, I am on a MacBook Pro, so I do not have a trackpad outside or a mouse, so I'm just doing that on here. I'm going to write my name, and I am using kind of the fat marker tool here. We can change the size of our pencil, of our marker, by clicking this little arrow right here, or our highlighter. You'll see there's a highlighted there. We can also erase things here. We can clear the entire page, or we can just use the erase tool like that. The other thing that Google Keep allows us to do is this drag and drop. It allows us to select specific text or images or pictures and move those around or resize them. So it's like a marking tool. So if we needed to move stuff here, if we click right here, it will allow us to change our background. So we're going to have a couple of different options as far as what the background of this whiteboard looks like. You'll see here we can have squares, so it can be graph paper. We can have dots. We can have traditional, you know, lined paper, or we can have none. So as we get to an iPad, right, if you have an iPad Pro or some sort of device like a Surface, you can actually write on that in those lines and keep notes and different things like that. Your students can also do this as well on their devices, their Chromebooks as well. So there's a lot of different applications that you could use this with. So then if we click over here, we have undo, and it will just go back and undo everything I've done. Now what we can also do here is this either makes this screen full or where it's in our current window. So again, this will take it full screen. Then if we go to three dots, we can click a new drawing, we can export this as an image, or we can delete the current image. Over here on this arrow, this will just take us back to our notes. So we're gonna title this, "This is a drawing in Keep." And we'll just hit enter there. And you'll see that it stays here. So the other option that we have is if we have an image, so let's say we have something with text, we'll pull this up. And right up here in the top right-hand corner, I wanna edit this drawing. So what this does is this basically pulls the image into my background. And then what I can do is I can actually annotate or highlight different pieces of text while I have that text on my Google Keep. You can also do this in Google Docs as well. But so this is editing an image that you already have in Google Keep. So if we go back here, you'll see that it's highlighted here. It takes a second just to update, but we're gonna close this. You'll see that that is there. If I refresh, it'll be there. I can also do this on another image. So let's say we grab an image here. If we're in an art class or we want to show something. So when we click on that, we just pull up the tool here. Right? And you'll see that I can draw on the actual image, right? So we can click undo. Those are some glasses. And then we'll go back. And you'll see here's the image that we had before. So this is how you add a drawing. Now, if I want to take this off, right, or I want to delete this, this is the same as for any other drawing. We would just click the three dots. We can delete this note. Again, we can always add a label. We can add a drawing to a drawing. We can make a copy of it. It'll just create another thumbnail there, so we have two of the same thing. If I go back down here, I can grab the image text. I can also copy this straight to Google Docs. And if we do this to Google Docs, it'll pull up a new Google Doc. If I click on open, you'll see that it'll pull that image inside of my Google Doc. So what does this look like if you have students in your class? Well, if I find an article online, I can then push it out to all of my students through Google Classroom, right? I can just have them make a copy of this doc. They can edit their own stuff. I don't actually have to create that. Or if you have slides, you could also do it that way, but you would probably just do that in slides, not in Google Keep. So this is more if you find stuff online. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna slide to the left. We're gonna do this on the iPad, and then we'll do it on the mobile device. All of the tools that you had on the desktop are actually all the same on the iPad, the tablet, and the phone. So we'll just go through those and do those really quick. So here we are on the iPad, and you'll see that those keeps have come in. So it's just in a different location. So the drawing is right down here in the bottom left, and I'll mark this with an arrow. But when I click on new drawing, it's gonna pull this up. I have the option down here at the bottom of an eraser, a pen, a marker, or a highlighter. So if I do the marker, again, you'll see that this is gonna flow a little bit easier because I'm just using my finger. And I'm writing my name there. I can also highlight things. There you can see that I'm highlighting. The pencil, it's easier to switch. And you'll see that you have the same options. You have the color options here. You also have the size options that you can do here, and you could add different things like that to that. So when I go back to the cropping tool here, we're gonna pull some text, hopefully. All of that's touching, so that's the text that I'm gonna move, so I can drag and drop that and move that up there. Let's say I wanna grab my name. It's gonna pull that whole thing together because all of those texts are touching. So that's how you would do this on a iPad. Again, when you click on the three dots, you can send this to somebody else. You can delete this. You can also see your grid, which will give you the background there. So you can change it again to the lined paper, the graph paper, the dotted paper, or the blank. If I wanted to send this, I can share this. It's going to pull up all the sharing options that I have. I can airdrop it to somebody. I can save the image. I can save it to files. I can copy it, right? It's already in Google Keep. So if I just click the back arrow right up here, you'll see here that it's gonna pull up right in my Google Keep drawings. So now what we're gonna do is I'm gonna pull up my phone, and we'll go to Google, we'll go to Keep. And I think I just disconnected, so let me reconnect here with Air Server. There we go, so we're on the left. And if we get back to Keep Notes, you'll see right down here on the bottom left, we have the little art tool, the paintbrush. So we're gonna click on that. We'll see a new note here. I'm gonna go to a pencil. I'm gonna change my color to purple, make it a little bit smaller. And there's the note. If I wanted to grab a piece of, you'll notice that it's not touching anything else, so I can grab that. I can move that around. I can also zoom in and out on that, make it a little bit bigger. So there's that. If I want to erase different pieces of text, I'm hitting my erase. I'll go back in and just add some things. So you can see, it's pretty easy on a phone. If I click on my three dots up here, I can show the grid. And it'll pull this up. I can have a square background. I have to click accept, right? There's your graph paper background. There's your dotted, click accept, and so on and so forth. So the great thing about, at least with the drawing tool on Keep, is it's consistent across all three platforms. So this is how you would do this on all three. Again, if you wanted to delete this, I'm not going to delete it because I want to save it so you can kind of see the progress as you're going through Keep. And you'll notice that it updates in Keep on all the devices if we go through and refresh. So if I go back to Google Keep here, all the images that we just created, both on my phone, the iPad, and the tutorial will be here. If you have questions, go ahead and let me know. Stick around for the closing of this. Thank you for watching this video all the way till the end. And thank you for what you do for kids on a daily basis. If this video saved you time, energy, and frustration,
go ahead and like, subscribe, and share with your teacher friends. You can subscribe by clicking up here, or you can watch another video either here or here. Again, I love you, I appreciate you, and I'm glad that you're here.